Have you attended or conducted any large meetings or webinars using Teams? I'm sure you have. And there is one common problem. There's no differentiation between chat and questions. There are formal questions coming for presenter and there are operational things happening on chat. Someone is asking about audio video problems, slides, am I going to get recording? These are operational things. They should not get mixed up with the actual question answer. That has always been a problem, but now it is solved. Because in Teams, we have a separate Q&A option now. Earlier it was an app, now it's an option. So let's see. It's very simple really. When you create a meeting, go to meeting options and enable Q&A. That's all there is to it. Now let's come to a meeting and see how to use it. Now before you do that, it's a very important thing to understand that who can ask questions, who can answer questions. Now, logically, you will say, okay, attendees will ask questions and presenters will answer questions. That is not the way it is. Yes, attendees can ask questions, but organizers can actually answer questions. Any person who has to answer questions has to be an organizer, not a presenter. So put even presenters as organizers for this purpose. We'll see how to get that done. Create a new meeting from calendar and go to meeting options. In that, you have to just enable Q&A. Technically, that's the only setting there, but there is one additional related setting. People who should be actually answering questions are usually presenters. But for the purpose of this app or this feature, add them as organizers or co-organizers, co-hosts, whatever you talk about. Now, let's save those settings, come back to the meeting. Let's say the meeting has now started. People have started joining in. Some are presenters, some are attendees. Before anything can happen, you have to configure Q&A. And the Q&A configuration button is available to you when you are in the meeting. So go to the meeting, look at the menu on top. You will see Q&A button. Enable the Q&A button. You will see a pane on the right side. In that, you will see a gear or sprocket icon. Click on that. And now you have to configure this for this meeting. Yes, of course, you want to enable questions. It may sound counterintuitive, but you switch off the answers. Because if you enable answers, everyone can answer. We don't want that. And then, do you want any question to come directly or you want to have the ability to moderate the questions? Generally, we want moderation. So, enable moderation. That's it. Now, let's see how this actually works. So, let's assume there are multiple people who have connected. Assistant is the organizer. Boss is the presenter. We have also made him a co-organizer. And sales and Nitin are users. Users means attendees. So as a person, what can I do? Go to Q&A, ask a question. I can also do a post. They just look different, but practically same. Now, whenever someone asks a question, nothing is seen by anybody else. Why? Because there is moderation. Only the organizers will see review questions. If they publish the question, then everyone else will see. Now, because we have said boss is one of the organizers, boss can actually type the answer also and everyone will see the answer. So that's how the Q&A works. Now, another way of doing Q&A is where the presenter is not going to type anything. They're just going to discuss or talk about the answer or maybe show a demo. In that case, all that you have to do is accumulate the questions, publish the useful questions, and then at the time of Q&A, presenter will choose the question, answer them, nothing to type. So in that situation, the presenter does not need to be added as an organizer because presenter is not typing anything. So these are two variations of Q&A. Now, what can you do using a Q&A? There's a little bit of formatting, bold, italic, link, and something like that. Nothing great. But most importantly, you need transcript of that. So yes, after the meeting is over, of course, you will see a separate tab called Q&A and all the questions answers are there. To my knowledge, there is no export button, but you can just select all, copy paste, put it in Word or any other tool and then do whatever you want with the transcript. Even if that doesn't happen, if you conduct large events like this, the fact that the Q&A is available to you for past is going to help you manage events and future trainings as well. So that's how you use the Q&A part. That's it for now. Thank you.